Here it is, just a typical control panel. Again, totally similar to what you can see in a classic Windows kind of environment. Hey guys, and welcome to Nomadic Dmitry channel. Today we're going to talk about Q4 OS. And to be honest, this OS, I mean, I've heard about this one before. The main reason why I wanted to try this one is because this one is similar to Windows 2000, kinda. I just really like it in that sense. I like the simplicity and that kind of, how to say, the functionality of Windows 2000, if you wish. And in the previous review we actually talked about Deepin OS, and I know some of you guys didn't like that review. I mean, the reason why probably I didn't educate myself much on the operating system. So today basically I'm going to repeat the same. I'm just trying Q4 OS and I never used it before, so let's try that. Alright, so let's go ahead and open this one. So this one is based on a Trinity desktop environment, and I definitely heard about that one before, because this one's like a fork of KDE as far as I understand. So basically it's like a KDE, but like in the previous time. So it's like KDE before it became like so much glancy and all that. Blah. After you install the Q4 OS, you see this dialog. And basically you can just pick any options you want, but before selecting any options here, just take a look right here. So what do we have here is just like really similar to like XP 2000 kind of look. I have my computer, my documents, my network places, web browser. This one is not Internet Explorer, guys. This one is a Concur. I cannot pronounce that one, but basically yeah, this is like a good browser. Let's open up the start menu. So here's the start menu, and of course it looks like super similar to what you can see in Windows XP, actually not 2000 XP. So let's open up this one. Again, totally similar to what you can see in a classic Windows kind of environment. Even this one, like you press find, files and folders, and you get this one, guys. This is like super similar to Windows, but I mean, hey, this is fun. So we have this dialog, welcome screen. Let's press install applications. This looks nice, right? Basically just like a typical kind of app store. And I mean, even the icon here, like take a look, it looks like Windows install kind of icon. I mean, oh my gosh. So I already installed the VNC media player here. How about we install Chromium? Okay, right. Click doesn't work, let's press install application. Have applied no desktop profile. It's highly recommended you apply desktop profile before installing. Okay, all right, so let's check this one, desktop profiler. What is that? Okay, so basically it just asks you to pick the proper desktop environment. How about we pick the Trinity? I don't want to try it KDE Plasma. No, I want Trinity. Okay, but why does it ask me? I think I already like selected it before. Let's click this one, full feature desktop with web browser. How about we just pick this one, like common utilities and stuff like that. All right, so that's the profiler. I mean, guys, I already like picked it once before. Like, why is it asking again? And this is strange, but let's see what does it install. This is all strange because I already picked this one before. I don't know, guys. So if I go here, for example, accessories and multimedia, you see I already installed the media player here, VLC media player. This is just like I installed through the typical like sudo apt-get kind of Debian kind of installer. But here, what is that desktop profiler? Why? This is what I don't like about Linux, typically. All those kind of tools on top of the tools and all that. Guys, I should say that it basically took forever. I don't know, it was like 20 minutes. It took even more than the installation of this distro itself. So this is not good. So this desktop profiler, I don't know, didn't like that part. But okay, finish. Did it change anything? Let's see, did it actually install any additional applications? I mean, I don't see any difference yet. I mean, it was installing for such a long time and I don't see any difference at all. Yeah, all the same stuff that we had, basically. I mean, anyway, let's just explore the operating system. So what I like about that is that, okay, it has the file manager. And this file manager, I mean, just imagine, dual pane file manager right from the start. So basically, you don't need to install anything additional. Like the Crusader is installed from the box, basically. So you can just use it right away. So this is cool. Programs, accessories, utilities. What do we have? Okay, Midnight Commander, this one actually installed. So this one was not installed by default, this one I installed. Next, editors. Midnight Commander editor and text editor, okay, right? This is pretty good editor. I mean, I'm totally fine using this one. So, and of course we have scientific calculator, the typical KDE calculator, that's all right. But what do we have here? We have the control panel, guys. Control panel, just remember, like in Windows. So when we press here it is, just a typical control panel. And we have internet and network. I mean, it just totally looks like something like from the Windows, like 2000 or XP, and even this go button, like here, what we can change here. I mean, I don't see any way to disable it, but I think if we go to customize toolbars, I think we can just like remove it from here. Boom, done. Folders, I mean, totally the same system like you see on Windows, web browser. So web browser, that's interesting. There's like all the components right here. Ah, basically settings for the web browser right there. Okay, but the web browser itself is right there. And the web browser is a Conqueror. I'm sorry, my English is kind of rusty today, and maybe all the time, I don't know. Alright, so here it is. So it's a web browser and file manager, which is cool. Yeah, I mean, just a typical browser, but you probably would want to install Chromium, I mean. But just, guys, take a look. This is like from Windows, like Internet Explorer kind of era. I mean, just the typical behavior looks kind of from something like from that era. I actually have a review about Mandrake 8.0. This actually reminds me in some ways, because it's like more like old Linux from that era, basically. And okay, this welcome screen again, something like from Windows 98 kind of era. So let's open install applications. Let's try to install Chromium right now. What about this? Okay, yes, finally it's downloading right now. Chromium setup wizard. Oh my gosh, this is like something from the Windows era. It doesn't feel like Linux. Okay, passed. Okay. This is interesting. Seriously, I mean, I just like it. It seems like indeed they just like cloned something from the Windows. This whole toolbar, I mean, show desktop button, it all looks the same again, all that stuff. Yeah, I mean, the keyboard layout switch, the paste clipboard tool. Alright, completed, next, finish. Alright, so I have Chromium right here. The Chromium is installed. I mean, it looks kind of old even, like, what version of Chromium is that? And by the way, this is like 32-bit version. I just installed this one in the virtual machine because I just wanted to try like the most simple 32-bit version. So yeah, 2020, so it's kind of recent version. What else do we have here in the repository? VLC already installed, multimedia codecs, and all that. Pale Moon, yeah, Pale Moon is actually that web browser, like lightweight web browser, you can also try it here. I mean, it feels like really good for the like old computers right here, like Wine, yeah, of course Wine here, and all that. Yeah, what else? GIMP, of course GIMP, Blender, and all that. I mean, it looks kind of powerful actually. Set auto login, what about this one? Do you want to enable automatic login, enable auto login? Yeah, sure, enable auto login. Login me to desktop right away. Okay, now enabled. Switch to kickoff start menu, turn on desktop effects, what is this one? Yeah, turn on desktop effects enabled, please login again to see those effects. Okay, install proprietary codecs. Okay, multimedia codecs are installing. I mean, it feels exactly like Windows. I don't know, guys, what do you think, but I personally feel this way. And if you like comfortable with Windows, you're gonna be comfortable with Q4 OS. And even this, like, run the command, how about this, ls, and it shows the list of the commands actually run, and it's gonna show this, like, the list of folders you have. What else do we have? Look again, start menu. Yeah, and this is like start menu progress, and there's actually like startup folder right here. I mean, exactly like in Windows, guys. Codecs seems to be installed, which feels great. I mean, and you can install any typical applications that you like. All right, how about this? What happens if we right click here? Again, typical stuff. Properties, and this is a bit different from what you see in Windows. For example, it has the permissions, has the URL. I mean, I don't know what's the point of URL here, because this is my computer, but that's okay. Preview, there's no preview here. All right, here it is, guys. So this is the review of the Q4 OS, which is like super, super simple Windows kind of like environment. And I mean, I totally like it because it's simple. It even has the history. I mean, what else can you expect like from Windows kind of system? Thank you, guys. If you like this video, please subscribe. Please press the like button and there'll be more videos. And let's turn this off. Turn off computer. Trinity desktop environment, closing applications. That's it.